What's up, y'all? Gerald here, creator of Gospel Chops and your host for this YouTube channel, back with another video. I saw a clip yesterday of another bishop from North Carolina who appears to me to be an old school bishop, having old school holiness church. He brought up a couple ladies from the congregation to give them some love and hug them and welcome them to the church community and let them know that they were free to come anytime and, well, just basically show them love and welcome them in. And I thought that the way that he did it was loving and welcoming and caring. But after the video, I saw that members of the LGBT community really cut this preacher to pieces. And I said, okay, I had to think to myself, well, if that was the wrong way to do it, then what was the right way? And let me go ahead and show the video of what happened in the church service, and we'll discuss it afterwards. So let's check it out.
Thank you. I'm going to come to church. I'm not going to tell you what to dress. I'm not going to tell you nothing. Let God be your God. God loves you enough to make a choice wherever you want to live. So listen to church people. What I'm telling you, if you feel that way, your feelings is real. We're all born into sin, shaping into the living. And just like you may be in a lifestyle, I was in a lifestyle, oh my God, adultery, fornication. Thank you. What I'm telling you is, whatever happened, I don't know nothing. I can't say, well, you were raped, unless that's why this happened, or I don't know why. Whatever the reason is, God made you in his image.
Yes.
And God loved you.
Yes.
There's two wills. There's a permissive will, and there's a will. So when we made it his image, is not legalism, religion. This image is like him. So if it's not just the LGBT community, it's people that smoke, drink, do whatever, party, our lifestyle has to be like him.
Yes.
And all I ask you is just to keep coming to church. Won't nobody bother you?
That's right.
Nobody won't look at you crazy. But if you try this church, if you try God, I promise you, you'll see like this. So all I'm going to pray is lift your hand. Otherwise, I'll pray y'all. I'm just going to say, God, show them your will for their life.
Yes.
You don't have to quote 100, but the Bible says, step up. We know the Bible. We don't have to say that. Love and kindness have I drawn. Love and kindness have I drawn. So whatever, does everybody have a decision? Whatever took place in your life to cause you to choose the lifestyle you choose, I pray that God heal you from that decision.
Yes.
We were all born looking like our parents, but we'll die looking like our decision. Right. I want to tell you, living for God is right.
Right.
And God made them males and females.
Right.
And today, I promise you, I just wanted to minister the love of God.
Yeah.
To show you that you can have love for people and stop in spite of their lifestyle.
Yeah.
I believe in men and women being together in marriage. That's what I believe. But because people are not where I am in God, I'm not going to show them the way. I believe God can change all of my mind, change all my decisions. Here is, I was a stone to you. Y'all understand? I sold drugs, but God changed my mind. I ran dope from city to city, but God changed my mind. And he changed my heart. We all need a change. And I pray that God will do whatever he needs to do in life. Now, if you don't want change, that's okay. But I believe he won't change, he wouldn't get over
it.
The Bible said, how can you say Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Spirit? So, Father, I pray right now that you continue to love on them. I pray right now, whatever was the past, it won't be the future. We love you here. And we believe God, you're part of the family of God. Well, we need to tell people what's right or wrong. All of us need to know what's right or wrong. You can love the hell out of people. I just wanted to let you know. Because I'm back there, you said this people tripping. I don't want to be saying that. I know I feel uncomfortable. I don't want you to feel uncomfortable.
You hear me?
I love you. All right. You love me too? All right. Come on, y'all. Come on. In Jesus' name. Now, when y'all decide, it's a big drink, y'all. When y'all decide, it's my life and I want to serve God, y'all come up and tell me, and we're going to take you. I ain't going to take you to that. You don't want to do it. When y'all decide, in Jesus' name. Come on, y'all clap your hands.
Now, when I initially saw that video, it took me back to old school church, to my childhood, to my youth. Old school preachers who would pull folks up out of the congregation and give them that special prayer, give them the invocation, and welcome them into the church. I thought this preacher did everything that he knew to welcome them into that church community. I'm not saying he did everything right, but I think he went out of his way to be welcoming and loving and caring and concerned for their souls. Now, he obviously made some assumptions that I would not have made based on their appearance. I wouldn't advise that you judge a book by its cover, ever. Some of my biggest wins in business have been because someone judged me and underestimated me based on how I looked. So I wouldn't advise that. But I thought that the preacher did his best to welcome these two ladies. He gave them hugs. He told them, "You won't be judged. You won't be talked about here. All I ask is that you keep coming to church. Just hang around. Just be a part. And at some point, perhaps you'll make a decision in your own time to become a Christian." And I was okay with that because I've been in that position. I've been the other. I've been the outsider in a black church community. When I was coming up as a youth, I enjoyed listening to rock music. Well, let me just be real with y'all. Heavy metal music. I rode my skateboard. I love BMX bikes. I love skating half pipes. And I always said, "Dude." And then y'all have to forgive me. I'm from California. We do it a little different here, but that's what it was. So I was always different from the black church community, even though I was raised PK. I was the outsider. So I was always put in a similar position as these young ladies, where I was asked to come up for extra prayer, special prayer. Even when I learned to play the organ in church, I was taken off the organ many times in revival situations. "Come here, brother, let us pray an extra prayer for you, because you different. You ain't like everybody else." So in that way of being different, being an outsider, I look at it from a different perspective of where these two ladies were standing. And I kind of understand how awkward that can be because I've been there. But I also see a pastor that's looking to welcome them in, who's showing concern, who wants to guide them in a direction that he feels is right within that community. So I wanted to show this clip and open it up to the viewers of this channel to get active in the comments and educate me, because my concern is, if this pastor did it wrong, then how should we do it right? How should Christians approach those in the LGBT community? And don't say, "Don't approach us at all," because that would be an antichrist type position, and we know that's not true. I was born and raised Kojic. We know LGBT community is in church every Sunday, so you're not antichrist. So that's not it. But if this is the wrong way to welcome someone into the fold, how should it be done? What's the right way? I wanted to open up the comments on this post and invite you to educate me, because it threw me back to my childhood and it put me in the same position as those two young ladies standing up there in front of the entire congregation, in front of the preacher, getting that special prayer. Because they saw something or sensed something, that you were different from the flock, that you were other. I thought he did a good job. It wasn't perfect, but nobody's perfect. But whether you're part of that community or not, how do you feel about this? What's the right way to approach the LGBT community to welcome them in to the Christian community? I want to know what you have to say. Meet me in the comments and let's get busy, because I want to learn from you. And I think it's important that church folks learn from you. Like the video. Subscribe to the channel and share the video so we can get more musicians involved in the conversation. And like I always say, y'all, always remember and never forget, without the gospel, it's just chops. Until next time, peace.